Hey guys, welcome to my commentary on the Martial Way. I am Khalil Shabazz, founder and chief instructor of Black Phoenix Jeet Kune Do, located here in Atlanta, Georgia. In the 1970s, there was a huge cultural explosion of martial arts in the black community. Martial arts schools were popping up all over the West Coast and the East Coast, as well as a few places in between. Most historians attribute this to the many black soldiers who were returning home from being stationed all throughout the Western Pacific, including Japan, Okinawa, Korea, and of course, Vietnam. Hollywood took notice of this cultural explosion and began to magnify it by infusing martial arts into black cinema. Arguably, 80 to 90% of the action-packed blaxploitation movies had the star perform some sort of martial arts. While Hollywood magnified many, many more were left out of the limelight, never receiving their just due, nor having their impact on the martial arts world justly acknowledged. With this being the case, I'd like to introduce you to some of the people who I refer to as the unsung pioneers of black martial artists. And these guys weren't actors. I'm talking real deal martial artists. Degree black belt Grandmaster Steve Muhammad is the co-founder of the Black Karate Federation and the organization's first president. He's also one of the most dynamic and celebrated figures in the history of American martial arts. From his days as a tournament competitor with an unrivaled championship record to becoming a trainer of fighting champions in the thousands worldwide. Born in Topeka, Kansas in 1944 as Steve Sanders, he was the youngest of several siblings, all of whom were raised in a tight-knit and fairly athletic family. In high school, Mr. Muhammad became an outstanding athlete who excelled in football, baseball, and track. He later attended Kansas State University on a football scholarship before leaving to join the Marine Corps. While in the military, as a member of the Pathfinders, he received his first real exposure to the martial arts. Training with the Pathfinders was similar to training with the Green Berets. It was intense and highly disciplined. During his military years, Mr. Muhammad was stationed at Camp Pendleton, which is in Southern California. Twice a week, he drove north to Los Angeles to train in Kempo with Ed Parker. Even after he was later transferred to El Toro Marine Base, he continued to travel to Los Angeles. Mr. Muhammad's training was eventually interrupted with the tour of duty in Vietnam. The experience of fighting in Vietnam gave him discipline and a first-hand look at the reality and brutality of combat. After his enlistment was over in 1963, he returned to California and immersed himself in the study of Kempo with Ed Parker. He earned his first black belt 3 years later under Parker's instructors, Dan Inosanto and Chuck Sullivan. As a tournament competitor, Mr. Muhammad became a member of the West Coast Karate team. During those early days of sport karate, he faced renowned fighters such as Joe Louis, Al DeCascos, Chuck Norris, and Benny the Jet Yuquerez. Many tournament veterans called him the fastest hands in karate. He later received the ultimate tribute from the late Bruce Lee, who said, "Steve Sanders has the fastest hands I've ever seen." In the decades following Mr. Muhammad's magnificent tournament career, he became interested in developing a more personal approach to fighting and began to introduce his own techniques in his training. Some of his theories, such as brain sight and the principles of mathematical fighting, have revolutionized his art. The quiet-spoken Muhammad has twice been awarded the Golden Fist Award by his colleagues, and he has been nominated for the Black Belt Magazine Hall of Fame for his outstanding contributions to the martial arts. He's the co-author of Championship Kempo and The God Side of Kempo, as well as Brain Sight. In 1982, Steve Sanders joined the Nation of Islam and changed his name to Steve Muhammad. Steve Muhammad has also found time to appear in films. His most notable role was in Enter the Dragon. In this classic Bruce Lee movie, Muhammad played the role of Jim Kelly's instructor. Additionally, Steve Muhammad has worked with the actor Wesley Snipes for several years as his bodyguard, and he has accompanied him all throughout his entire film career. Steve Muhammad is a legend. He's helped to pave the way for all of us to do what we do. CJO, I salute you. Please seek out more information on Steve Muhammad. His story, like so many others, deserves to be heard. And always remember, each one, teach one. If you want more content like this, look up Black Phoenix Jeet Kune Do on Instagram and on YouTube. Follow me on IG and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell. You can also find me on Facebook. And if you visit, make sure you like the page. If you want to train with me in person and you're in the Atlanta area, visit my website, BlackPhoenixJKD, for my locations, class times, as well as my price list. If you aren't in the Atlanta area, consider signing up for my online training academy. And just the same, all of those details are on my website, BlackPhoenixJKD. Lastly, if you have any questions, concerns, or considerations, you can private message me via any of those social media platforms, but you can also send me an email directly from my website. I want to thank you for tuning in. It's Khalil Shabazz for Black Phoenix Jeet Kune Do, and I will see you in class.